Hello and welcome to the Cryptocurrency News Channel. Today we're going to talk about Bitcoin's correlation with the S&P 500. And recently, the correlation has hit all-time highs. What you see here on the screen is a graph of the correlation. Now, correlation is basically how related one thing is to another. And in this case, it's basically saying how much does the S&P 500 affect Bitcoin. Now, correlation goes from negative 100 to 100. Negative 100 means that if S&P goes up, Bitcoin goes down, and vice versa. 100 means Bitcoin goes up when the S&P 500 goes up. 100% is perfect correlation. Negative 100% is perfect negative correlation. Obviously, unless the Bitcoin is S&P 500, it's not going to be one or negative one. So it's always kind of like you can see, like from May 2018, it's been up and down with a median at about zero. But now it's actually hit basically an all-time high. It's finally surpassed, I think, the value back in late 2018. Late 2018, if you do remember, was when we did have somewhat of an economic snapback, and Bitcoin kind of fell during that time as well, partially because of the hash war and partially because of other things. And right now, you can see the correlation going up again because of the whole pandemic thing, and the smart stock market and Bitcoin recovering at the same time. So it is, I don't think it's a coincidence that it actually goes up during these like really high times of stock market or really low times of stock market. I think when the stock market like acts all suddenly and in drastic ways, Bitcoin is definitely pulled by it. But if the stock market just kind of oscillates between even, then Bitcoin does its own thing. So Bitcoin is what they term a risk asset, which I kind of agree. It's basically a more vile, it acts like a leverage asset with relation to the stock market. It's basically a much more risky and volatile version of most stock indexes. And Bitcoin is the least risky out of all the major coins. So what the graph really tells us is that usually Bitcoin has zero correlation with the stock market because the median is zero. But in special times like this, when there is a pandemic, when there is a big recession, when people are losing jobs, then Bitcoin does sort of parallel the stock market because in the end, Bitcoin is actually an asset. It's not just like something by itself. It's not like a currency. People don't think it's a currency. It's not independent by itself. It is an asset, and all assets are actually affected by the turn of the market. The 1 year correlation has also risen to lifetime highs of 37%. Now, in terms of like statistically, correlations are strong when they're above 90% and extremely strong when they're like 95 or 99%. 37% is, even though for cryptocurrency, the S&P 500 is fairly strong, in statistical terms, it's still fairly weak. So over the entire length of time, most of the time, Bitcoin does not actually have a correlation with the stock market, which is what we usually see. But during these times of panic and these large market fluctuations, Bitcoin has a very, very strong correlation with the stock market, and that's why it acts those like small peak times actually pull the rest of the times up. And the article also says one should note that readings between 30 to 50% imply a relatively weak correlation between variables, but it is over 60% over the last month or so. And I think like if you really look at it, it's actually been growing over the last 3 months or so, since basically it hit like a low in the negatives, probably in April, like March or April, and then it just suddenly shot up. And it tends, I think that it will actually attend to that, and that's why I think Bitcoin has a pretty good chance of actually tanking. Come August or September, if they don't actually renew the CARES Act, because that means the $600 extra a month of unemployment goes down. People are going to realize, hey, I don't have enough money to feed my family anymore. And some people are going to sell their cryptocurrency assets. Now, a couple of people have said, like, well, people who have lost their jobs don't own crypto. I think that is completely wrong. There have been a couple of people in chat who have already said to me that they actually own crypto, but they did get laid off. Layoffs happen at all levels, blue collar and white collar. And yes, if you're in tech, it's less likely that you got laid off, but that doesn't preclude people actually being laid off from technical roles if demand actually in the market actually goes down. So I do actually believe that a sudden market crash, a flash crash of the S&P 500 or the Dow Jones Industrials will actually affect Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies, and that's why I think a flash crash is actually possible. Because in those instances of flash rises and flash crashes, that's when correlation with the stock market is actually the strongest, if you actually look at this graph. So that is the analysis for now. Let me know what you think. Like and subscribe and hit that bell notifications button. Thank you and have a nice day.